Unyielding and remorseless, the Brazen Claws are famed for their stoicism and their grim determination to succeed. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint the red and blue quartered armour of the Brazen Claws. Now, to prepare our model for painting, we've already undercoated it here with Mephiston Red Spray. Once that was dry, we also went over it with a thinned down coat of Mephiston Red paint from a pot, just to make sure we've got all those areas the spray might not have covered. Now, once that's dry, it's time to start blocking in the blue areas of the miniature. For this, we're going to start off using Cantor Blue, and in two different ways. First of all, we're going to use a small airbrush to draw on the lines on the miniature to show where the quartering is going to go. Once the lines are drawn on, we'll then go back in with a larger brush and fill in the gaps. First of all, our small airbrush with Cantor Blue. So let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. Now, we're going to add quite a bit of water here to make sure that the paint is nice and thin, so we can draw those lines a bit easier. We're also going to make sure we've got a nice thin point on our small airbrush here, just to make the drawing those lines a lot easier. Then, onto our miniature. So here on a Brazen Claw, the model's left top and bottom right, our top right and bottom left, need to be blue here, as per the colour scheme of the Brazen Claws. So what we're going to do here is start by drawing lines onto the miniature. Using points on the model, we know we're in the middle, such as this ridge on the faceplate here. We'll draw that up there like so. We're making sure the brush is over the right-hand side of the model here to make sure the line is in the centre of the model, going back like this, like so, back towards the face ridge here as well. On the back of the model, on the backpack, it's a lot easier here as there's lots of rivets and things to draw the line with. So we're going to use those as guides, drawing that line down the centre like so, making sure the paint is towards the left-hand side of the model here. Then over here, we're just drawing the same down there. You can see we're drawing a nice thin straight line like so. We're going to do that over the top of the backpack too. On the bottom of the miniature, here on the groin plate, we'll draw a central line, this time with the paint on the this side of the model like so, going down like that in the center, and then we'll fill in the bottom here as well. Now chances are that you're not going to get a perfectly straight line when you're doing this, so you might need to go back later on the Mephiston Red paint and correct that. That's not a problem. Then we're going to grab our medium layer brush and just fill in those areas of the model up to and including the line itself. Again, be as neat as you possibly can here. Don't go over into the red areas if you possibly can, but if you do, we can always go back later on and correct it with Mephiston Red. Okay, there we go. We've blocked in the blue on our space ring. You can see that the lines are nice and straight, and now it's time to move on to the next stage. Alright, up next, let's shade in those blue areas, and for this, we're going to use a contrast paint, Black Templar, as it's perfect for this job. Grab your small airbrush for this. Let's take some Black Templar from the pot and onto our palette. Now here we're making sure we're keeping our brush nice and pointy, and we're not going to thin this down as Black Templar comes pre-thinned. Make sure we've got a nice point on the brush, then it's onto our miniature. Here, we're applying this shade into the recesses of the blue armour, so very carefully bringing our brush back into the recesses like so, all over the model like this. You'll note the contrast paint falls nicely into the recesses like this and will give a really cool contrast effect. Be as neat as you possibly can all over the model, but don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back and correct it with your Cantor Blue. With that done, that's the blue sections of our armour shaded. Alright, up next let's highlight the blue armour up. We're going to start with a highlight of Canador's Sky first, and once that's applied, a second highlight of Lothen Blue over the top of that, nearer the edges of the armour. For both of these, we're using our small airbrush. Let's take some Canador's Sky from the pot and onto our palette here. Now, for a highlight like this, we're going to be thinning it down quite a bit to make sure it goes on real smooth and also quite subtly. There we go, bingo. Make sure we've got a nice point on the brush. Then, onto our Space Marine miniature. Here, we're applying highlights on the very edges of the blue sections of armour, so we're just going to be working our way around each section of armour like so, very carefully, just painting small lines on the edges like this. Now, take your time on this, it's going to take you a little while to do the entire blue sections, but don't worry, it's really worth spending your time to get nice, neat highlights. Up next, another highlight, this time Lothen Blue, applied to the very edges of these armour plates. Here we're using the edge of the brush on areas such as the shoulder pad here to get a really fine highlight all over. There we go, that's the highlights done on the blue sections of the armour. Up next, let's grab our pot of Mephiston Red again as we're going to tidy up those red areas to make sure that those lines are super straight. Grab your small airbrush for this and take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. As always with the base paint, we can add a little bit of water here just to water it down, make sure it's nice and thin so it goes on real smooth. Then, on our miniature, here, anywhere where we're not quite happy, where the line's totally straight, we'll just apply it right now. Just touch those areas up. Anyway, we've gone over with either the base coat or any of the highlights or the shade, just touch it up now, make sure that red is super straight. So now we're ready to paint the red areas. And to paint the red areas of the armour, we're going to follow the same process as we did for the blue. That's a shade and two highlights. Here, the shade's going to be Flesh Terror's red contrast paint. Then we'll highlight up with Wild Rider red and then Troll Slayer orange. Again, for all of these, we're using our small layer brush. First of all, that shade. Let's take some Flesh Terror's red onto our palette here. And again, we're not going to thin this down. We're just making sure our brush has got the right amount of paint on it and it's got a nice point on it too. Then onto our Space Marine. Here, we're applying the Flesh Terror's red onto the red areas of armour, again into the recesses between the armour like so. Take your time, be as neat as you possibly can. But again, if you make a mistake, you can always go back and correct it with Mephiston red if you need to. Next up, we've thinned down some Wild Rider red, and again, with our small layer brush, we're applying some very fine highlights all around the armour plates like this. Again, take your time on this. You don't have to rush, be as neat as you possibly can. Next up, we'll take some thinned down Troll Slayer orange, and again, use a small layer brush to add an edge highlight to the very edges of the red areas. Once that's done, we're going to go back and paint the rest of the model that you've not painted so far with a Baden Black, ready for you to paint it later. And with that, our armour is done. And that's how you can paint the red and blue armour of the Brazen Claws for your army. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.